What's up, fuckers? Another shit face Saturday. We're here in the shop. My name is motherfucking Phallus Rex, as you already know, and this is...
I'm the Anime Dipper. Welcome back once again, you guys. A bunch of bullshit, but we are going to chug on with whatever we got. So, a lot to talk about today, but not really a lot of time to do it. So, we'll just stick with the essentials.
Alright. First shot we're going to do tonight of this lovely Lead Slingers Napalm Cinnamon Whiskey from a veteran-owned and operated company.
We would open it right in front of you guys, but we've been trying to shoot this thing for about 30 minutes now, but camera difficulties, that's all we can say. The corks, fucking corks.
As anime pours this, I'm going to preface this shot. This shot's going out to one of the true legends and innovators of lucha wrestling, and that is Chavo Guerrero Sr., who has passed away after a bout with liver cancer. And anime, I think you said it best the first time we tried this, so.
Even though I've never watched any of your matches, man, you're a freaking Guerrero. You gotta respect you. Fly high, my man.
It's good on the way down.
But that aftertaste.
The aftertaste is something to be desired. But, fuck it.
Anyways, we got our prediction video for the Elimination Chamber, or, as Phallus has informed me, what do they call it in Germany?
They call it No Escape, because they don't want any references to the gas chambers from Nazi Germany.
So you gotta love that. We have freaking the card pulled up, and we're gonna give our predictions one at a time, just for you guys, because apparently... that's what we do.
All right. Added just on the 10th of, which was Friday, the kickoff match. Mojo Riley versus Kurt. Nobody gives a shit Hawkins. What's your pick on this one?
Well, before we get into that, we got to do what we do best. And we forget about this all the time, but we got to pack... dip and spit. I got the skull mint because fucking Copenhagen decides to fucking put metal shavings in their shit and fuck with my world.
Hey, I ain't posing this week, motherfuckers. This is a fresh can of only dipped once of Cope Straight.
Love you.
That was Prince Phallus, little dick, interrupting just to tell me he loves me. And I want to expand on that topic for a minute. I came home from work the other day, and my son, who I love dearly, and my nephew, who I love just as dearly, we're in the living room minding our own fucking business. I walk in and say, "What's up, queer bait? How you doing, fag magnet?" And my son asks, "I'm not fag magnet, am I?" What the fuck? I mean, honestly, one's just as bad as the other.
Fucking skull mint, man. I hate it. But, anyways.
Oh, yeah. Skull mint. It makes those heavy flow days more tolerable.
Fuck off. Fucking. But, anyways, we got a great card tonight. Freaking. So, let's go ahead and with the first prediction, Mojo Rollins versus Kurt Hawkins.
Yeah, Kurt Hawkins versus Mojo Raleigh. And I did a little reading on this while... you were shorting out the technical difficulties. And it's a damn shame you can't find a decent American-made camcorder. But anyways, Mojo seemed to like to talk about the fact that he was friends with Gronk, Ron Gronkowski, or Rob Gronkowski. And congratulating the Patriots on their Super Bowl victory. Fuck you, Brady. And Kurt Hawkins went on Twitter and said, "Mojo Raleigh's career is like Rob Gronkowski's contribution to the Patriots winning the Super Bowl. You didn't play." And much like Mojo Raleigh's existence or career, it's non-existent. So I'm saying Mojo's going to go over with some Gronk interference because Gronk has been known to show up at NXT tapings when Mojo was on the roster there.
Well, either way, I really don't give a shit about this match. Just like Ballas Reds, it's a...
Both of these guys have deflated balls, so don't be surprised if Tom Grady comes in and starts grabbing motherfuckers.
Exactly. So, either way...
This is your piss match. Because the rest of the card is pretty fucking stacked.
Exactly. So let's go ahead and get on to the second one.
The main card, kicking off the show, is going to be a 2-on-1 handicap match. Apollo Crews and Kalisto taking on the new heel, Dolph Ziggler.
Dude, like, I have to say, I've been waiting for the Dolph Ziggler heel turn for a long time. I think he'll do really good as a heel, because as a face, he wasn't...
He was boring as shit.
He wasn't there. But, like I've always said, being a face is very hard, but being a heel, nobody gives a fuck. You can be a heel and do whatever the fuck you want.
Exactly. So. It's so much easier to be a fucking heel.
So, Dolph, I really hope you do good as a heel, but, I mean, it's a handicap match. Unless freaking Dolph Ziggler just ends up kicking him in the dick, just like he did with Baron Corbin all those months ago.
I'm giving a W to Dolph.
I really want to.
Because they can't take the steam off of this fucking heel turn.
I would hope not. But, I mean, either way, hopefully it'll be a pretty good match, even though it is a handicap match.
All right, next on the card. The Irish Lash Licker. I mean, Kicker. Why do I always say that?
I don't know.
Fucking wishful thinking. Against Mickie James. And, you know, Mickie, she's one of the few female competitors in the E that was there in the Divas era. And why do they make it so, like a dirty word to say Divas anymore? That's what they fucking are.
I mean, it was a great time with Mickie James, and it was a great time even when she did her porno. Y'all don't know about that. Go look it up.
Yeah, I know about it.
But anyways, I want to give this one to Mickie James so bad.
Oh, yeah.
I really do.
I'm saying Mickie's going to go over, because it'll give Becky that rematch at the biggest show of it all. Because this is, remember, guys, Elimination Chamber, this is SmackDown's last chance to build up the storylines for Mania. So, just when you think you might have it figured out, they're going to change the questions on you. Yeah. So, don't say you got the answers.
So, I think Alexa Bliss will be in her corner, freaking something like that. She'll freaking be interfering somehow, and Mickie James will pull out the W on that one.
And the next match is the second of three, and I'm going to go ahead and say, Divas matches on the card. Nikki Bella versus Natalya.
Ish.
This is going to be a go-take-a-piss match, because, quite honestly, if they didn't have this on the card, nobody even fucking give a shit about their fucking rivalry.
Exactly.
Except for Natalya's little comments on fucking SmackDown this past week, when she told Nikki, basically, that if she wasn't married, John would be over there fucking hurt.
Okay, one thing. For two things, Tyson Kidd, I'm sorry.
And Tyson's stuck at home watching a fucking cat anymore. Thanks to Samoa Joe. How many people Joe gonna fuck up in the E before they give him the Del Rio treatment?
I don't know. Joe has a lot of heat behind him, but we'll get to that later. So the next match
is they call it a tag team turmoil. It's a fucking gauntlet match between American Alpha, the Champs, the Usos, the Ascension. What the fucking Ascension?
I thought they were gone. Not gonna lie.
They were dominant in NXT, now they're just fucking jokes. Heath Slater and Rhino. Really? They're fucking still doing it? Breezango? And the Vaughn. What the fuck?
I think it's just so they could throw a lot of people.
Every fucking tag team on SmackDown in this motherfucking match.
But it's
quite frankly, the only two teams that matter in this match are going to be the Usos and American Alpha.
Now, I really want to see what they do with this. Like, it's a gauntlet match, of course, but I really want to see what happens, because these are for the tag team titles.
It would be very interesting to see either Breezango or the Vaughn Villains come out with the tag team titles. But
I don't see it happening. I really don't.
Me neither. I just said it'd be interesting.
Yeah.
I'm going to say the Usos are coming out with straps on this one.
Really? I want to see the Usos, but I think they're going to try and either give it to American Alpha, or they might throw the he has kids freaking angle and give it back to Heath Slater and Rhino.
I don't think so, because I read online that Heath Slater's kids put themselves up for adoption.
Either way.
All right, next match on the card. This one's going to be fucking interesting. Luke Harper, who, even though I haven't really seen SmackDown, I saw some fucking highlights, cut a fucking awesome promo. Don't ask me to quote it, because I ain't know.
We haven't had time.
But all the buzz is he cut an awesome promo. This is going to be a fucking nice launching point for him to get a solo career, distance himself from the Wyatt family. And Randy Orton's already got his match at fucking Mania, whether it be with the SmackDown champion or the Raw champion.
I think what they're going to do is they're going to keep him on the SmackDown title. And that... the prediction for the Elimination Chamber will be what I'll say later. But either way, I really want to give this one to
Harper. I want to give it to Harper.
I want to give it to Harper as well. I mean, he deserves it.
Fucking Bruiser Brody looking motherfucker.
Hopefully he gets it, but I don't know if they're going to pull out that RKO out of nowhere. So I really want to give it to freaking Harper.
Harper with the fucking backwoods super kick. Or that nasty ass clothesline.
Or trying to give him a Sister Abigail. Oh. Like he did with freaking, tried to do with freaking Bray Wyatt a couple times in the Rumble.
Never thought of it that way. And the next match for the SmackDown Women's Championship. Cocksuckers chasing the fucking nomenclature on me. That's wording.
Yeah, okay.
Alexa Bliss defending her title against Naomi. This match is going to be the only fucking female match on the card. It's going to be worth watching, really.
Yeah, I really want to freaking see what happens here. I'm giving it to Naomi.
I am too.
Naomi
so,
is...
there's going to be two Fatus leaving the fucking arena tomorrow night. With gold. Alexa, I love you. You're a great chick. But
I don't think she's ready for that. Though.
Naomi is the most popular SmackDown female competitor. Because I'm not going to fucking say the women's championship. The Cooter title. The Cooter title. That's what it is. It's a SmackDown Live Cooter title.
But either way... let's just hope it's a good match. I really want it to be a good match. So, let's just see what happens.
And now, after that, is the main event. The Elimination Chamber match, or the No Escape match, if you're one of our German viewers, which I don't think we have any, but if we do, Guten Tag! We got John Cena, the face that or the champ that runs the camp, AJ Styles, Bray Wyatt, Dean Ambrose, that motherfucker ought to be locked up. The Miz, he ought to be in fucking federal prison for his shitty acting. And the fucking dark horse in the match, Baron Corbin, who did get the win on SmackDown in that fucking fatal four-way. Which, I just saw the highlights, didn't see the whole match, but I was, what?
Like, they've been giving a lot of steam for Corbin lately. And The Miz is the Intercontinental champ, right?
Yes. Or that's the only time not being defended at the Elimination Chamber.
I thought Dean Ambrose was... did it? Dean lose his title?
No. Dean is the champ.
I was about to say.
That just shows how much the Intercontinental title means anymore.
Like, when... either way. But I love that they put Baron Corbin in this. I love that they actually threw freaking AJ back into it. But I want to see Bray Wyatt win this.
I concur. I want to see Wyatt with the strap. I'm thinking my order of elimination is going to be The Miz, then Ambrose, Unfortunately, as much as I love him, AJ, then Corbin, and it's going to come down to Cena and Wyatt. Because you know they're going to fucking protect Cena as much as they can, because according to the rumor mill, and everybody knows how fucking accurate that shit is, after Mania, Cena's leaving the company. He's going to focus more on his Hollywood career. He's going to go the Rock route. Even though, if you remember, 4 or 5 years ago, he's like, I'll never leave. I'm always going to be here.
I don't believe it. But either way, the eliminations that I think are going to happen, of course, The Miz first, because fuck The Miz.
Yeah, fuck The Miz.
I honestly think Corbin's going to be eliminated second.
No.
Just hear me out.
All right, I'm listening.
Then they're going to put Ambrose on third. Then they're going to put Cena on fourth. And then they're going to put AJ and Bray Wyatt as the last two.
Oh, that would be a fucking hell of a match.
Now, I really do want to see that, but as freaking Fallas over here has said, they're going to protect Cena as much as possible. So, hopefully I'm right. I really want to be right about this. But we'll just have to see.
And, all right, let's do a shot. This shit, I like it when it goes down, but, I mean, it's like somebody dumped the whole thing of cinnamon and some shellac.
Yeah.
So, I don't know what Afghanistan liquor tastes like.
I don't either.
And you were there. You know, some fucking, whoever the veteran that runs this fucking shit had to have fucking tried to find a way to make diesel fuel fucking potable. I'm glad I didn't go for the straight bourbon.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
But either way, this shot goes out to the Elimination Chamber. Hope it's good, and hopefully most of our predictions are correct.
Yeah. Whew. Now, there's one other thing that I want to... Well, actually, there's a few more things I want to talk about since shit's working, right? Knock on wood. 27 years ago, in 1990, before this fucker was even a twinkle in his father's eye, there was a match in Tokyo. It was billed as the first pro wrestling super fight. It took the top Gaijin, which white boy, for New Japan, against the top Gaijin, white boy, of all Japan pro wrestling. For New Japan, you had Big Van Vader, a.k.a. Leon White. And for all Japan, you had Stan the Lariat Hansen, who, if any of y'all fuckers watch WCW, know his big thing was to come down the ring with a big old chow in his mouth. And the one the person I'm thinking about the most is Lex Luger. And a Clash of the Champions, Stan Hansen just jumped you from behind, beat the dog piss out of you, spit right, boom, right in the middle of his chest. And y'all know Lex had them big fucking pecs. So it's just like a big pool in between the titties. This match lasted all of, from start to finish, 18 minutes and change. 5 minutes into the fucking match, Vader rips off his fucking mask. And when he does, his fucking eyeball's hanging right here on his fucking cheek. And if y'all don't think Vader wasn't a bad son of a bitch when he was wrestling, you're full of fucking shit and you need to eat a cock. This motherfucker pushes it back in, and the only thing holding his fucking eyeball in his head was his fucking closed eyelids. And he wrestled like that for 13 fucking minutes.
Vader, that's a badass indeed.
And, you know, I've got the match right here. And if you look at anime, they're not even really trying to wrestle. Let me put it full screen. They're just like drunken brawling with a few wrestling moves, putting it, look, I mean, just automatic, just, you know. It's fucking insane. This is the most popular match in Japan that Red Shoes hasn't officiated. I mean, you got 85,000 fuckers in the Tokyo Dome cheering for two Americans to just beat the dog piss out of each other. And I'm thinking some of them are just remembering Hiroshima and Nagasaki. I mean, just, as Dusty Rhodes would say, it's a fucking clubbering.
I mean, but either way, we'll probably have to start wrapping this up here soon. But just a few announcements before we go. Tuesday Night DVC will be starting next Tuesday because fuck VideoPad Pro and pretty much just a bunch of bullshit, but we will get it back next Tuesday. Don't worry about it. A lot of good stuff for this matchup. We already recorded it. We already did everything for it, but fuck VideoPad Pro. That's all I got to say. All
right. And I've got two more things before we wrap up. One is a where are they now topic. And the focus on this is a wrestler some of you may remember, Gene Snitsky. Or he was commonly known before his departure, Snitsky. A fucking beast.
With teeth to match.
Yeah, with green teeth, real bad back knee. He's no longer wrestling. But if any of you fuckers are up at 3 in the morning watching infomercials, look around for a, I think it's called a Power Pro pressure cooker. This motherfucker is selling that shit.
Wow. I would never thought of that.
Yeah, this motherfucker is selling pressure cookers. Now, the last thing I want to leave y'all with is something I spoke to Anime about earlier today. Something I saw on Facebook that just really got my mind cranking. If wrestling had a Mount Rushmore, what four wrestlers would you put on it? And I've thought about it, and here are my four. Ric Flair, Dusty Rhodes, Nick Bockwinkle, and Jerry Lawler.
That's pretty good.
Nobody from the current era fucked and they ain't done shit to deserve it yet.
Nah. My four, obviously, Ric Flair. You always got to put Ric Flair at the top. Eddie Guerrero, because you got to love Eddie Guerrero.
Nice.
You got to put in Taker. I mean, Taker's still going, and he's still freaking 51 years old?
Yeah.
And the fourth one, Steamboat.
Nice.
Steamboat. You can't forget about Steamboat.
Nice, nice, nice.
See, I know a little bit, but I mean, either way, Ric Flair is always on top because he is the damn, he's the greatest. You can't fucking deny it.
Now, for those y'all watch, tell us your Rushmore at the bottom in the comments below. You know, we honestly, we do read them if they're there.
Which there aren't.
But so y'all just voyeurs, y'all ain't adding the shit, but that's all right.
And next week, if there are actually comments on there, next week during Shitface Saturday, which we will be bringing back, we will read out the comments and freaking put them and give our little diagnosis of them. Hopefully there are a few. If not, then we'll just go on with it.
Because, I mean, arguably, HBK and Triple H and Sting could all have their spots in there.
They could belong on there, but, I mean,
another one, Vern Gagne.
Definitely Vern Gagne. Who was that fucking, what was his name? I forgot, it's been so long.
I mean, if you really want to go,
either way,
Mount Fuckmore, you could have Ellsworth, Barry Horowitz,
Hornswoggle.
Yes, Swoggle, and, Louis Spicoli. Which, wow, every fucking promotion he was with treated him like shit except for ECW.
Dang, man.
ECW makes McCully look like a badass. But I digress. It's time to wrap this shit up. And once we wrap up, me and Anime are going to sit here and watch the rest of this match and try to just make our own commentary because it's all in Japanese. But because I know he's never seen this shit. I want to see his reaction when he does. If you want to watch it, go to Bing, type in Big Van Vader versus Stan Hansen. It'll pop up. You ain't got to fuck with YouTube because I tried looking it up on YouTube and they just show little clips of it, just the eyeball hanging out.
Copyrights. Channel.
And so we're going to wrap this shit up because honestly, I feel like this is our first real shit-faced Saturday since we've been back.
It has. It definitely has.
Go ahead and pour you another one of this fucking cinnamon diesel fuel concoction. And here's to all y'all that fucking watch faithfully. Here's to a good card elimination chamber. And here's to a fucking hell of a match we're about to watch. Until next time, I'm Phallus motherfucking Rex Saiyan. Grab it by the puss.
And I'm the Anime Dipper. Thanks again, you guys, for coming out. And as always, y'all stay awesome.